Chapter 3, Analyzing and Recording Transactions. Introduction. Chapter 3 provides an in-depth exploration of the principles, assumptions, and concepts that guide accounting standards and financial reporting. It emphasizes the importance of accurate record-keeping for informed decision-making and discusses the role of regulatory bodies in setting accounting standards. The chapter also delves into the use of a conceptual framework by the Financial Accounting Standards Board, FASB, and highlights the differences between the U.S. Generally Accepted Accounting Principles, GAAP, and International Financial Reporting Standards, IFRS, in different countries. Learning objectives. By studying this chapter, you will be able to 1. Understand the principles, assumptions, and concepts that guide the development of accounting standards. 2. Explain the revenue recognition principle and its impact on recognizing revenue in financial statements. 3. Describe the expense recognition, or matching principle, and its importance in aligning expenses with associated revenues. 4. Identify the cost principle and its role in recording assets at their historical cost. 5. Discuss the full disclosure principle and its requirement to report any business activities that could affect financial statements. Key points. The FASB provides clarification and guidance on how accounting standards should be applied, considering the effects on U.S.-based companies. The IASB faces challenges in providing detailed guidance for its standards due to the diverse legal and judicial systems in different countries. The conceptual framework sets the basis for accounting standards and guides the preparation of financial statements. The revenue recognition principle directs companies to recognize revenue in the period in which it is earned, regardless of when cash is collected. The expense recognition, or matching principle, requires expenses to be matched with associated revenues in the same period. The cost principle states that assets should be recorded at their value at the date of acquisition, usually their purchase price. The full disclosure principle mandates reporting any business activities that could impact financial statements. The separate entity concept ensures that only activities related to company operations are reported on financial statements. The conservatism concept advises companies to report uncertain or estimated expenses and/or losses, but not uncertain or estimated revenues and/or gains. The monetary measurement concept relies on a monetary unit, such as the U.S. dollar, to value transactions. The going concern assumption assumes that a business will continue to operate in the foreseeable future. The time period assumption allows companies to present useful information in shorter time periods for easier comparisons and evaluations. Real-world application. Understanding the principles, assumptions, and concepts of accounting is crucial for individuals pursuing careers in finance, auditing, or business management. By applying these principles, you can ensure accurate financial reporting and make informed decisions based on reliable information. For example, as a financial analyst, you may need to analyze a company's revenue recognition practices to assess its financial performance accurately. Similarly, as an auditor, you would rely on the full disclosure principle to identify any potential risks or liabilities that could impact the company's financial statements. Conclusion: this chapter provides an overview of the principles, assumptions, and concepts that guide accounting standards and financial reporting. By studying this chapter, you will gain a solid understanding of the revenue recognition principle, expense recognition or matching principle, cost principle, full disclosure principle, separate entity concept, conservatism concept, monetary measurement concept, going concern assumption, and time period assumption. These concepts are essential for accurately preparing financial statements and making informed business decisions.